And again, Karen, as we sway to the right, pull down on that opposite hip. Pull down, feeling that tailbone and that big pelvic muscle, that glute, pulling into the earth, making some space. Thank you, Minister. But because we're not all the way up, we're not in Baddha Konasana. Bring the feet forward. I call it Omega, like the Greek letter Omega. So there's a circle here, and that will help us get even deeper into those tight outer hip sockets. Use the hands forward if you like. If you want a little extra, raise the hands off the earth. This is, we're using our own body weight as weights and pulleys. Big arc, not straight across. I'm going to the left. I'm reaching with my right hand, pulling down on my right hip. Nice diagonal stretch. Reach to the right, pull down on the left. I like this. Let's do this a few more times. A couple more times. Reach, 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 reach. Inhale, compress that belly, just rolling the belly up, massaging everything, just squishing the liver at this point while expanding the kidneys, the queen of all organs. Back to center and cascade forward and forward. Gently uncurling. Gently lifting those knees up. I know that pose is a little hard on the outside of the feet, so give the feet a little massage. Say thank you, feet. A moment of discomfort for a lifetime of helpful benefits. A few more cat-cows. Inhale. Big tuck. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, really squeeze those elbows back, fill those lungs all the way down, the Sherpas, and I was in Peru hiking on the Inca Trail, and was told their lungs, because it's rarefied air up there, not so high as the Sherpas, but their lungs reach all the way to their waist because they're maximizing the benefits by maximizing the capacity for the lungs. Push through those heels. This nasty plague we're dealing with these days, it attacks the lungs. This is our chance to heal our lungs, rejuvenate our lungs, let them work to their maximum to protect us, to keep that fresh, oxygenated blood moving throughout the body, being our best healthcare system. Cascade forward. Grab those ankles, big cat. Uncurl, massage those beautiful knees. Two more times, just nice Paschimottanasana. Forward, forward. If you can reach a little further, fingertips on the earth, or grab the ankles or feet, big tuck, stretch, bend those elbows, elbows to the knees, uncurl. Shoulders back, float the head one last time, inhale, float. Give me a little back bend there, just hanging, soft shoulder. Cascade. Inhale, Ardha. Halfway up. Exhale. Big tuck. Uncurl, massage those calves, knees, thighs, shoulders back, head floats. Dandasana. Easy Dandasana, no real strength, just sitting up nice and tall, nice long neck, no compression in the cervical vertebrae. continue this more passive hip opening, and bringing the right leg. You don't have to mirror me, nobody can see. I'm bringing my right leg into my inner thigh. Janu Shirshasana, Janu, knee, Shirsha, head. Head to knee pose. Learn to practice yoga, learn a new language. All right, nice big lift and cascade forward halfway. Elbows up, elbows up. Halfway, pull down on that right knee. Pull back on the belly button, below the belly button. Compress, 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 compress. Inhale, float it up. Exhale, melt it down. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, fold and hold. Hold it for 3-4 breaths. And again, make those breaths work for you. Inhale, expand the ribs and then squeeze it out. Inhale, squeeze it out. Relax the shoulders. Inhale, squeeze it out. Belly to the spine. Last time. Uncurve, letting the hands drag across the floor. Rotate the shoulders. Head floats. Inhaling upward salute. Shoulders down. Right. Even if your arms have to be out here. So once you go this way, then they start hiking up. Keep it open. Keep that tree open. Taking our left hand, rotating it in the socket. Shoulder work. Placing it at the base of the spine. Adding a little twist here to our Janu and twisting over that left leg, reaching on the diagonal, reach with that right hand, again, flat, hip opening, pull down on that right knee, that right hip, compress below the belly, massage the internal organs, reach, 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 and when you can reach no further, melt it. Inhale, Ardha, whatever you can reach, the calf, the ankle, the outside of the foot. Inhale, halfway up again. Fold and hold. Pull down on that right hip. Maybe sway the torso to the left another half an inch, a centimeter, feeling that stretch deep in that right hip side. Two more restorative breaths. Relaxing that right hand and reaching on the diagonal again, lifting all the way. Curl up if you need a little support. Otherwise, coming up, rotate that right shoulder, hands to the back, fingertips or palms, your choice. And open that chest. We just compress the chest. We're opening. Try not to drop the head back. The shoulders hike up. The cervical vertebrae, those little delicate little things, they hold up this massive ego hanging out up there. So just lift the chest, fill the lungs, and come back to center. Gently lifting that right knee up. Give a little massage. Extend it. Massage that. But because we just torque the spine, for me, after a spinal twist, I like to align the spine, click it back into place, all the way forward, Paschimottanasana, forward, forward. Inhale, Ardha. Exhale, fold. Grab those ankles. Big cat tuck. Rotate the shoulders. Float it up. deep restorative breath, soft shoulders, just let the flesh, the muscles, just tendons, ligaments, just drape over the skeleton. Before we do that whole sequence on the opposite side, left leg in, right leg straight out. What is our knee called? Remembers? Ernesto, you're the only one here. Margo, I'm so sorry why I keep calling you Margo. Margo Channing. I just played a Margo, so maybe that's why I got it.
You know something?
What?
Me? You know something?
Very good. Janu is knee. Excellent. Shirsha, head. Shirshasana, headstand. So we're going to do head to knee pose with a little exaggeration. Inhale. Maximize the benefits. Pull those shoulders down halfway. Hover. Pull down on that left hip. Use your left hand if you need to. Inhale. Exhale all the way forward. Ooh, feel that stretch. Deep, deep stretch. Inhale away. Flex that right foot. Maximize the benefits. Fold and hold. Let gravity do the work. Relax those shoulders. Just melting like a swan, a beautiful swan, nestling into itself. No ugly ducklings here. All beautiful swans. Squeeze it out. One more deep restorative breath. And uncurl. This is, I have very bony feet, so I'm going to put my blanket under there because it is a little too hard for me. Uncurl one last time. Inhaling upward salute. Rotate the right shoulder. Really see if you can isolate that. Hip socket, shoulder socket, same thing. And expanding the chest. Again, I've got a little bend in my elbow, so I'm just not hurling my arm back. I'm extending, reaching back, extending those ligaments, tendons, right arm up. Spiral to the outside of the leg, left shoulder down, and reach. Reach. Slowly, oh, collapse, extend, make space in that spinal column. Let those little discs plump up, no compressed discs, and melt all the way in. Inhale, Ardha. See if you can reach a little further, that left. And see what you can grab outside of the foot, the ankle. Hand on the floor, preferably on the outside of the foot, a little deeper spinal twist. Oh, pull that left hip socket into the earth. Give a little whack, feels good. Wake up, surrender, open up, please. Ah. Two more. Soften the shoulders, become that swan, just melting into your right leg. And then reach with that left arm. Float it up, use the power of the trunk of the tree. Rotate that left shoulder back. And take your little stretch. Chin tilted down, just ever so slightly. Use that head as a weight to compress those belly muscles, not collapsing. Ah, fill those lungs. Coming back to vertical. Release that little knee, rotate that ankle. Compressed. Upward salute. Cascade forward. Align the spine. Inhale. Exhale. Grab those ankles. Big cat. Massage those knees. Bending those knees, feet flat on the floor. Flat on the floor. Go into the floor for some more twists. If you like, you may want to take your blanket and just make a low cradle just to protect those cervical vertebrae, but maximizing the benefits. Don't just flop down. No, 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 no. Control. Soft shoulder. Using the power of the trunk of the tree. Soft shoulders. Oh, but you're giving yourself a wonderful massage on that spot. Oh yes, that feels good. Take a moment for a little break. And what you can do is take the palms of your hand and put them right at the top of the thighs and feel that heat. Feel that heat that's been generated by those deep, focused hip openings. Releasing all that pent up energy. It's hot, it's stardust. Living in a state of this energized but relaxed state. Tuck the chin slightly and bring those knees in one at a time or both into the chest. And again, those rocking things we did onto that right pelvic bone, knees to the chest, push them away. Towards the left, push the knees away, hands on the knees, pushing the knees away while we try to pull them. Maximize the benefits. A few more rotations, massaging that big pelvic muscle we demanded so much of. Knees to the chest, extend those. Flexing those feet and pointing, flexing and pointing. And then just in however you like, both feet rotating the feet together or one out, one in. Open the toes. Then drop that left foot to the floor. Drop that right knee to the floor. Before we do our twist, we're going to take a little more spinal lifting into a modified bridge, nothing too extreme, but starting at the base of the spine, curl that tailbone up, relax those shoulders. The work is in the body and downstairs in the body. The hips, and the hips. Uncurl, tuck that chin, push up and hover. Relax the shoulders, push into those feet, raise the toes, push into the heels. Now lifting into a bigger, deeper bridge, larger bridge. Lift the heels, then lift the heels. I'm sorry, I'm being confusing here. Push into the toes. Then as you go higher, then drop the heels and feel that stretch in the thighs. And then tilt that pelvis forward and uncurve. Ernesto is giving wonderful sound effects, Karen. I don't know if you can hear him or not, but it's quite lovely. Woo! Feels good. Now just hands. I like my hands at 45 degrees. I don't like shoulder height anymore. I like little just cat back 45 degrees because then again they don't hike up. And bring those feet together, knees still to the sky, and just drop to the right for an easy twist. Keeping the left shoulder on the floor and taking that top hip, that left hip, push it away towards the wall in front of you. So so again, you get a deep, hip socket. If this is comfortable and you want a little bit more, raise that right leg and drape it over the left thigh. I'm very bendy, so I have to remind myself to keep my tailbone tucked down to keep the sacrum flat, no compression in the lower spine. So again, it'll give a deeper thigh stretch. Just enjoy to whatever degree. Check in with your shoulders. What are they doing? Are they gripping? Leave the right thigh, let ankle over the left thigh, and plant that foot. And take that right hand again, hip opening, gently pushing that right knee away. I like to rock a little side to side, massaging the pelvic, the sacrum. Gets my mind off the discomfort of this hip opener, which can be uncomfortable. Moment of discomfort, a lifetime of helpful benefits. Deep inhalation. Take it one step further, bringing that left knee towards the chest. Take those hands, interlace them behind the left knee. Using the right elbow to push the knee away while the interlaced fingers behind the left thigh pulls the left knee towards you. Oh yes, now we're getting that stretch searing down the back of the right thigh. Yes, it's uncomfortable. You have to learn to appreciate pain in yoga. I decided it's quite sadistic sometimes. If you like, raise the head towards the right foot. Come, extend the left leg to the sky. Take the fingers, reach up if you so choose, pulling that straight and let, oh gee, we're back in Jhana Shirshasana, Supta Jhana Shirshasana, head to knee. Roll the tailbone up, lift the head towards the knee. Deep stretch, melt into the floor, release the left foot to the floor, release the right leg, and coming into Baddha Konasana, soles of the feet together. Just let the knees fall open and the muscles relax. After a moment, we'll do that entire sequence on the opposite side. And gently bringing, squeezing those inner thighs together. Flatten the feet and bring the left knee in, I believe. Oh, left knee in. I can't remember what we did. Oh, we're going to do a little twist first. We're going to do a little twist first. Both feet on the ground. Thank you, Ernest. And drop the knees to the left. When you're ready, if you are ready, lift that left leg and drape it over the right thigh. Tuck that tailbone towards the wall in front of you, letting the right knee fall to the earth, deep thigh stretch. Great for all of us, not just hikers, not just golfers, not just tennis players or runners. It's good for everybody. Tuck that tailbone, flatten that sacrum, both shoulders on the earth. You want to give the neck or the head a little rock from side to side. Nothing too strenuous, just letting it float. Little bobble doll head. And gently rolling back onto the side. Oh, I remember. Woo! We've got the strength. Just push into that right foot. Just to align the spine. That little one-legged bridge pose. Oh, and curl down. Reach those arms through. Clasp that right thigh while we push the left knee away with our left elbow. A little rocky if you like. Tuck the chin, long neck. Soft facial muscles, no tension. Baby in a cradle. Oh. Then if you like, straighten that right leg. Then if you like, reach up with those hands. Hold the leg. Keep a little bend in that right leg. Don't hyperextend that right knee back. Just a little bend, pull the head to the knee, Janu Shirsasana, Supta, reclining. Oh yes, and relax. Drop the right leg, maybe give that right foot a little massage, a little reflexology, or the left foot, I'm sorry. Before you drop it to the earth. Again, Baddha Konasana. Ah, just let the arms float. What I like to do is push into the back of your skull so it presses into the floor, which will lift the chest up. Gently squeeze those shoulder blades together. And nestle in again, filling those lungs, making them larger, to take in more life-giving, healing, nourishing breath, oxygen. Very gently, sweetly flatten the feet. Bring the knees to the sky. Let's align the spine again with another deep passive, easy bridge pose. Tuck that tailbone forward, massaging the sacrum. Then the waist, then the ribs, lower ribs, upper ribs. Hands at the side, if you want to be a little more active, roll those shoulders back, clasping the hands underneath. Tucking chin, nice long neck. Once again, push, raise the toes, push into those heels. Drop the toes, lift the heels. Oh, feel that wonderful back bend. We are only as young and healthy as our spine is limber and soft. Once again, dropping the heels, release the hands, and uncurl. Slowly, take your time. Plump up those discs, lots of space. Push the pelvis forward. Extend the legs, taking a moment's rest. Mm-hmm. Once again, just raise the hands off the earth, rotating the wrists, separating the fingers, just play with it, make designs. Bringing the hands to the back of the neck, interlacing those fingers, cradling the skull in the palm of the hands. Fingers pointing down, thumbs pointing down the spine. And then gently raise the head just a quarter of an inch off the earth, elbows back, ever so gently pulling the skull away from the shoulders for a wonderful neck adjustment. Release the fingers, let them slide over the scalp. Fingertips massaging the skull. Oh yeah, really get in there. Pull. I like pulling my hair. Pulling. Just giving that scalp a massage until the whole body starts to tingle. Oh, massage behind the ears, pull the ear, gently, gently, gently. Massage the earlobes. Much ignore little ears. If you can get a finger in that wonderful curve, gently, gently, gently. Palms of the hand at the crown of the head, just at the hairline. And use the palms of your hands to massage the face, stimulating the hair follicles, improving hair growth, hair thickness, giving it new blood, oxygen, and slowly just let your palms start working their way down your forehead until they cover the eyeball. A little pressure. What colors do you see? I see turquoise, a beautiful Caribbean ocean. Squishing the eyeballs, giving them movement. And so just working your way down to those cheekbones, massage. Circular movements. Just as if you were having a wonderful facial, just spa, that are all closed now. Spa city, and we can't go. So we become our own best masseuse. Taking those fingertips, pinching the jawline, the chin, give the flesh on the chin a little pinch. Gently, don't hurt yourself. Fingertips right in front of the ear this time. Again, at the hairline. Coming back up to the crown of the head, the hairline. Hands floating to the sky, rotating those wrists. Reaching overhead, full body stretch. Raise a leg, reach towards the opposite wall, reach with the right foot, feeling the elongation on the side body, those intercostal muscles. Flex the toes back, float the arms to the sky again, let them float to the earth, floating through space and time. Into a much deserved shavasana. If your body is asking for something else, by all means, honor it, your practice, your life, your creation. Or just let the flesh, the muscles, the tendons, the ligaments drape over the skeleton. No resistance. Every exhalation, sinking more deeply into the earth. Inhaling through the nose, exhaling through the mouth. Inhale through the nose, exhale, sigh it out. If you are comfortable as you are, please feel free to stay as you are. Otherwise, awaken, prepared to greet the world again, having taken time out just for you. Full body stretch, head wagging, however you choose. Start your week with this exquisite practice of yoga. Rolling onto your right side if you so choose, resting there for a minute or two. When, if you're ready, gently lifting up, back into Sukhasana. Sukha, sweet sugar, sucrose. Hands to the knees, giving them a nice little last little massage. And palms facing skyward. In a mudra of receptivity, a mudra of offering. And again, if you find the torso sways a bit, allow it. We are not led, we are fluid energy. As the leaves move with the slightest breeze, so too we move with the slightest breath. Finding your center. Bringing the hands together, if you so choose. Miss Karen Ananda, Mr. Ernesto Ananda. Namaste. Namaste.